As we pray so that we can hear the word of God, let us pray. Everlasting Father, we are so much grateful before you this morning because of giving us this opportunity to hear your word. As I stand before your people, I pray that you use me as a vessel, that, Lord, the word that will come out will be a blessing to each and every one of us in our glory. Teach us your ways. May you be with us. In Jesus' name that you do pray and believe. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Hallelujah. Amen. I thank God because of this moment that he has given unto us to hear the word today. And I know the Lord is going to bless us. And I want us to briefly meditate upon the word of God from the second reading as it was led from the book of Luke, chapter 11, the gospel according to Luke, chapter 11, from verse 29 to verse 36. I am born again. I love the Lord as my personal savior. He has been good to me. All through, not that the path has been so smooth, but just because of his grace and his great love upon my life, I have continued to experience his goodness upon me, and I rejoice in him even in this morning. So I want us to look at that word, and these are words that were spoken by our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ while he was on his mission here on earth. And our heading of our sermon today is See the Light and Have Hope. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Tazama uone mwangaza na ukue na tumaini. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And now, while Jesus was on his mission here on earth, there is one underlying and very dominant challenge that he was facing every now and then. Of course, having been born in a certain native and being told, go and spread the gospel to the same place that we are born in, where everybody knows your parents, Mary and Joseph, and furthermore, they know the humble background of your parents, and then being told, go preach to the same people who know you even the way you are born, who know even your grandparents, who know even the way you have been brought up, the challenges and the like. That is one challenge that he used to face, because some of the people could hardly believe that what Christ could offer was something that was of great benefit unto him. Apart from what we call the doubting Thomas, that doubted that Jesus had resurrected, Jesus had this issue that he used to face all along. He met people who could not believe in his proclamations. He met people who could not believe the kind of miracles he used to perform. He met people who could not believe that surely this was the sent Son of God, the only Son of God who was incarnated to come and to save the world. This is the problem that Jesus was facing. He met some kind of people who were leaders and elders, some called Pharisees, some called Sadducees, and they could not believe that a new transition was coming. They wanted to hold to their beliefs and the oracles and whatever they believed in and what they did in the synagogue, and they could not love to see somebody who could overtake. That's why you saw somebody like the king who was there, the Roman authority, could not accept Jesus to go on because they didn't want to hear a king. So they would not believe the message that Jesus came to give unto them. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. They were doubting, they were in real doubt of how Jesus could perform all this. And if you read the word of God in the book of Luke, you start from verse 29, Jesus starts to explain about how things could unfold at that particular time. And he said, the generation that is here is an evil generation. It seeks for a sign, But no sign will be given to it except the sign of Jonah. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. A generation that looked for signs. A generation that looked for things that were visible, things that were tangible. How hard-hearted were them? And Jesus gives them an example of Jonah. You know, there are testimonies that are given out, and more than the message that was being given out by the giver of the testimony, you happen to believe because of just the testimony. Imagine in a normal situation, when you come out of the door of your house, we meet with a person and he tells you, "You know what? God has saved me. I was in the belly of a fish, or I was in a belly of a big animal under seas for 3 days and three nights. How could you survive? How could you be in such a place and survive and come to me?" You'll be so much touched, and you'll be so much empathetic to such kind of a case. And beside the message that Jonah bared, what he passed through was a testimony by itself. And through those kind of signs, and through those kind of miracles, and those kind of things that Jonah passed through, people believed. The people of Nineveh no longer hardened their hearts. They chose to believe in God, believe the message and the messenger, and they repented. And so Jesus is telling these people, if you know about Jonah, you don't even need to hear about something else. And then he tells them about Solomon. All of us read about the Proverbs, the book of Proverbs, the book of Ecclesiastes, the book of Songs of Songs or Songs of Solomon. And they are books that they are so much rich in wisdom. They are books that can enlighten you. They are books that can offer words of advice that nobody here else on earth can offer such kind of wisdom. Solomon was kind of a king that when he was chosen to be king, and he was given an offer, a very special offer, that just pray for God to do something unto you. And the offer that he gave out is that, "Lord, so that I can be able to reign well, just give me wisdom." And wisdom was richly dispensed unto him. And he really utilized it in a very great way. And in these verses, we are being showed of a queen that was even not part of the Israelite nation, but she traveled from far to come and listen to the wonders of Solomon. But remember, there were some people who were surrounding Solomon, and they could not at any particular time benefit from the wisdom of Solomon. But somebody traveled from far and was so much anxious to come and benefit from what Solomon could offer. I say that our topic today is see the light and have hope. Jesus continues to say about the light. We know how light works, and we know light comes to dispel darkness. And in verse 33, Jesus is saying, "No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under a basket. But when you light a lamp, you put it somewhere above." Even when you look at the lighting of this room, all the bulbs are put just up. Why? So that the light will come from up, and will come and it will be distributed down here. Even in your houses, wherever you go, no bulb is put on the floor. All bulbs are positioned where? Somewhere up, just below the ceiling or on the ceiling, so that the light will illuminate from a position where it will be able to light up the whole room. So Jesus is explaining that concept, that when you have a light, you must make a stand where the light will be somewhere up. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. To give an application to this message, and to apply it even to our situation today when we are passing through challenges of COVID-19, challenges of economic challenges and no other challenges that you might be having, or even in our lives in general, the way we are in our walk of faith. The Lord has shown his love in great ways into our lives. When you make a reflection on your life, when you make a reflection on your past, when you make a reflection on your career, when you make a reflection on your marriage and relationship life, can you see somewhere where God delivered you? Can you trace in any way a miracle that God did unto you? You know, some of us don't believe in miracles because we wait for miracles that will turn or change water into wine. Some of us will probably not believe in miracles because we are waiting for miracles that will come and find a lame person to walk, or we find somebody who is blind to have sight. Maybe some of us have not believed in God because you are waiting for such miracles to come and happen. But Jesus tells these people, you need no other sign but the people of Nineveh to come. And he tells them in verse 32, the men of Nineveh will rise up at judgment day with this generation and condemn it. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Wakati itafika huo wakati wa hiyo siku ya hukumu, na watu wa Nineveh wakuje, watawaambia nyinyi watu, watawalaumu, and they will condemn you. Why? Because they just repented by seeing what Jonah did. But for this generation, we have somebody who is greater than Jonah, who is Jesus Christ. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. We have somebody who makes miracles more than what you expect. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Sometimes we want God to work in our own way, in our own perception, and we fail to see what God is doing. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Zile njia tunataka kupitia, they are completely off the mark of what the Lord is working for us. Praise the Lord. So, 3 points. Christ is the light. And that one, we must acknowledge it and put it into our mind today. Ya kwamba Yesu ndiye mwangaza. In our lives, do we have darkness in any way? Whoever can dispel or overcome that darkness is only Jesus Christ. Number 2, Jesus explains this, that your eye is the lamp of your body. So you must work on your eye, or you must work on your perception. And he continues to say, when your eye is healthy, or when your eye is functional, your whole body is full of light. But when it is bad, your body will be full of darkness. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. How we see God working in our lives is what will make us to either believe in God, believe in his miracles, or believe in his working out. How many people today can stand and give news that are different from what people are saying that we are getting from us to us? How many people can stand today and say, we are not going to die, God is able to deliver us and heal us from COVID-19? Bwana Yesu asifiwe. It's only people who will check on their eye, because your eye is the lamp to your body. If your eye is well functional, your body will be full of light. I want to imagine Christians who are not having darkness in their lives, but they are having light and well-lit bodies within themselves. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Ile wokovu uko nao, ile imani uko nayo, na chochote ambacho Mungu amekupea kizuri, kikue kimejawa na mwangaza, just because you have checked on your eye. When you see, you don't see trouble. When you see, you don't see devil. When you see, you don't see your accuser. But you see the hand of God, the ability of God, and the miracles of God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Baada ya kufanya hivyo, jambo lingine la kufanya, it is to shine the light. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Like the way we have read, when you light light, you don't put it under that covering or under the basket. Upon that light would be of no use. When you have light, you have that candle, you put it somewhere up so that everybody will be able to access the light. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So angalia mwangaza wako. Angalia nuru ambayo Mungu amekupa. And you make sure that it is operational. And it will be beneficial unto you and even to people that are surrounding you. Be the agent of hope. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Because when you have light, you have three things. We said the light is Jesus. When you have light, you possess three things. One, you are somebody who have hope. You are somebody, when people are talking of destruction, you are telling them of prosperity. When people are saying that everything is going to crash out, you are saying that everything is going to work out. Miraculously, Bwana Yesu asifiwe. That's why the Bible tells us in Psalms chapter 20 verse 5, trust not in horses and chariots, but trust in the name of the Lord. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Because there is hope. Even if you don't have what it takes, you feel you don't have what it takes at that case. When you trust in God, you'll have hope that you shall overcome. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And I've seen it anyway apply in my life. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Number two, what you possess when you have the light, you have the way. Because Jesus said he is the way. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. He said he's the way and the truth and the life. When you reach to an end, in your life, because I don't know what you are going through, maybe you feel things are not working out. Maybe you feel you have reached the wall. You have reached a stopping point. Please don't stop. When you have Christ, you will have the way. He makes way even where there seems to be no way. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Number three, he is a problem solver. When you have the light, when you have Jesus, you have all the solutions. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Jesus never runs out of options. He has the solution to your problem. He has the solution to your challenge. Please don't be depressed. Please don't go to a stage even you are not able to eat because challenges are overwhelming you. As Christians, we are not the kind of people who are going to get thinner and thinner and thinner because we are being overwhelmed with the issues. But what will make us to get thinner and thinner and be depressed and be stressed and even welcome other opportunistic diseases is just because we don't know we have the light. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. But like our heading today, when you see the light, you will have hope. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And what will make you to have hope is to appreciate everything good that the Lord has done unto you. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Today you are not a casualty. Today you are not in mortuary. Today you are not in hospital. You are here to praise God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. You have all the strength. You can be able to listen unto me. Furthermore, you came to church because you know here you will have hope. You will meet with Jesus Christ and you see the light. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So be encouraged, but see the light. Don't be like those people who are undermanned, who are rebellious, who could not be able to experience the greatness of Jesus Christ, and they were with him all the time. Yet many people from far, actually, you know how the story of the Bible started. The gospel first came to the Jews, but Jews did not benefit so much because they despised what Jesus offered unto them. And when Gentiles came, people who are of different nations came, they repented. You remember the parable where there was this Pharisee who went before God, and then there came one Gentile who was a Samaritan, and the Samaritan just humbled and told God, I am a sinner, forgive me. And he was forgiven. But the Pharisee came and chest thumped and said, you know I give out my 10%. You know what I have done. I keep the 10 commandments. I deserve salvation, oh God. What happened? The alien who was not a Jew got blessed, while the one who was a native of the land was not blessed. Sometimes it happens to us that we fail to see Jesus Christ because we feel that we are so fit and blessings overtake us. May we not be those kind of the people. As the light comes, may we take advantage of it and may it light our ways. So let us check on our eyes, let us see Jesus Christ and the way he has done great unto our lives, and let us take the salvation that he has offered unto us, and he will continue blessing us. Shall we pray? Thank you, Jesus, because of your word. Thank you because of the light that you have lit into our hearts and even unto our lives, King of glory. We want to count every blessing that you have offered unto us, even in this time of COVID-19, that your name, Christ, is lifted up even high above every other name, and that you are going to work out for our lives in a very special way. Remember these, your people, in everything that they are experiencing. May they see the light, may we see the light, may we see the hope, may we see your way, may we see your solutions work out for us. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ that we do pray and believe. Amen.